It's full throttle on the pedal and inside.
It's like wide open on the. I don't know, it's a little bit more, but.
There's more there, eh?
Go again, like. Yeah, like it's wide open on the. Pretty much wide open on the.
Levers.
On the levers, but you can move the second lot of levers, moves more on the.
There's a setup issue with that throttle body, eh?
Mm.
Something's not quite right there, and that's why it's sticky when it's cold. But also, there's some power to be had if we give it full throttle. Mm. I'm ready to go for a test drive. I did realise last night that the speedo is in miles per hour. I had it calibrated perfectly. Absolutely perfectly. And then went, oh wait, it's in miles per hour. But it works.
Yeah, calibrated perfectly. We didn't have it calibrated perfectly.
Well, in kilometres, and it was in kilometres. I just converted it back to kilometres per hour. Yeah, when I recheck the U-bolts, yeah. Good idea.
Yeah, what it doesn't do? Move.
I was running it up last night, and there's little projectiles coming out of these tyres. It wasn't very nice. I wonder how many hours went into these headers.
No, there's a fair amount. They make it sound different, eh?
Yeah, absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
I've got all the extra little bolts off the side of the block. And the oil pressure, I put the little blanker in them. I would have liked to know how well that fan and radiator kept it cool previous. Bushes. I'd like to. Oh, yeah, it was these ones, eh? Those front ones, yep. I would have.
Those other bushes didn't fit.
I would have liked to spend a couple of hours just wiping all the surfaces down. It'd be nice to pull all the front out of it and. Just paint it up nice black again, eh? Get it coated.
Yeah, I've sprayed these.
Yeah,
just around there, just to give it a bit of.
Oil temp was sitting at like 90 last night, but I hadn't found a nice calibration for the temperature sensor for the trans yet, and so that was kind of interesting. But I've put some numbers in to start that calibration. Right, let's get it down, and I don't think we're going for a test drive, Jace.
Not the best. I'd say. Not only how much carrots out.
We'll let the fog burn off.
Yeah.
Let that crash disperse. Oh, it's breathed its last. There's a split under there.
The new hoses of it.
Come in. These are our gear buttons. So that's first, both on a second, this on a third, and overdrive is the next one. But you gotta pull that steering, Jase. Turn it.
It's all right. Oh, it's an MPV.
Woohoo! we calibrated the speed sensor. We actually had it within like 4 or 5 kilometers per hour. And I set up the speedo last night, so the speedo just sort of worked. It's really close. We've been adjusting the transmission shift and tuning it at the same time. Yeah. This thing seems to have a really, really tall dip in it. So it means that we don't need overdrive until it's well up in the speed. But we've got a shifter that's working pretty well for the setup. And I've just been massaging the trans shift to get it how we like it. Of course, later on, I can adjust the twiddly knob, put some more tunes in to make it how the customer likes it. But I need a base set of numbers to work from. This is actually one of our grazing clients right here. Right. So the cows don't come from very far away, eh? There wasn't quite a kick down then. Yeah. Would you like one?
I was expecting one.
You're expecting one there?
Yeah. Your throttle gave me a kick out.
So you can drive that okay? Or I can do it a bit earlier.
Depends on throttle. Like if you just want to do that right light roll and do it, it's quite nice. And then you do the.
This is the Okarari pub. Okarari Hotel there. Alright. There's a swimming pool. You can get in, and there's a hot pools apparently.
Oh, hot springs.
Yeah, hot springs. Famous Okarari Hotel. And a golf course, if you want to play golf. Do we have a golf?
Not very good at golf.
We could fit the golf clubs in the boot.
We could
definitely fit the golf clubs in the boot and go for a golf, have a golf. I'm no good at golf either, unless we take a shotgun and shoot the bunnies on the golf course as well.
Probably better at that.
You'd probably get away with it here.
Probably.
Do that again for me. Drop lock up off. Drop off a 50% throttle, you just been over it. I know about that kick out of that top gear, it looks like it could possibly kick. Are you gonna have enough brakes in the corner?
I think so.
Oh, those. That's done the warm up now. Can you get those four discs going? Those woodwards on the front. Oh, they actually did work.
Yeah.
Oh. So it's just the seat belts that are a suggestion.
Yeah.
I nearly put the laptop into the dash. How's it feeling?
Really? It's alright. You should have sounded the flip when I'm down, when I'm driving it first.
I know, but couldn't do it with the oiling.
No, not at all.
Yeah, so.
A water leak.
Multiple leaks.
That way.
Yeah, I know. Broken the cardinal rule. Don't drive it. I'm not driving it first. But a bit of acceleration. Hard acceleration.
Then straight to third.
There was no second?
No second. It accelerates quite good.
It does, doesn't it?
A bit of a hand second.
Okay, we can solve that. There's a road up the top here, either side, and we'll check in second. So it jumped first to third.
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
Okay. Basically, we've got a pretty good road tune there.
Yeah.
For a road drive, it's pretty good. So I can manipulate it up and down to suit the customer. So, you know,
now it runs.
Are the wipers a suggestion as well?
No, I haven't.
Let's wipe it. Oh, there they go.
Oh, there they go.
Yeah.
That was
a suggestion. I think that's a missed distribution system.
Just...
circle. Go up to that middle dump, turn around, head back. Do you want to hold a second longer?
I don't know, what's the reason for that one?
I didn't have time to look at reefs. Lock. Chase that beamer.
Fuck.
Hey Chase, it squealed the wheels.
Yeah, they hit me on the roof. I wasn't quite expecting it to do that, like.
Wipers are kind of just trying to keep the water down, eh?
Yeah.
It's a bit dull in the bump. So that sort of throttle, it had to be over 100 kilometres per hour to reach overdrive. So here doing 90 at top gear. You have to get 60% throttle for it to kick down. That works? Well, that's not right, shut down. What's the fuel temp at?
Fuel temp?
Yeah. It's running at 41 degrees. Coolant temp sits at like 80 degrees, 82 degrees, a bang on thermostat.
Yeah, that gauge is like 40 degrees.
Yeah, it's like nothing.
Mind you, it's sticking way the hell up on the thing, so we're going to look at it.
Yeah. So the main test drive's done. It's driving, doing everything that it's meant to do most of the time. Of course, there's little niggles that we need to go through and work our way through, which is the same as any aftermarket computer, just one step at a time. Now, I didn't actually trust the ECU was outputting everything correctly yesterday. I feel a little bit bad because I set up a couple of LED lights, and in fact, it works perfectly. Everything that we tell that ECU to do, it is doing with that gear change. But it is nice to know that 100%. So I now know, I can trust when it says it's shifting a second or it's in third or anything else, that's where it is. My box, my shifter box, working beautifully. It's doing everything that it should. The only change that I made was I made a little way that it was powered up in the relays. Was just run one more wire and just change it. And apart from that, it's pretty much working like it should. Oh, other things I did in the wiring. I hadn't seated one of the 5-volt wires properly to the twiddly knob over here on the dash. That was easy to find. I could see the voltage wasn't quite right, just working through. And I did discover that if you don't plug the can box in at one end, then it won't work like it should. I was doing some diagnostics last night and it was getting a little bit late. And I unplugged the wideband for some reason. And I was working at the other end, swapping wires around, and it wasn't working. And after 10 minutes, I realized that I had unplugged the wideband. So it didn't take much to fix that. And then I called that a night and went home. Speedo's working, happy there. Temp gauge, temp sender, radiator fan, all that is doing what it should. So the next time we'll see this, we'll probably be on my way to the dyno. So that's not far away. And I'm really looking forward to it. Two reasons. One, I'm really looking forward to getting the Zephyr done. And I'm actually really looking forward to catching up with Dave and having a bit of a chat. We talk quite a bit. And we bounce ideas off each other at times, and it's nice. This case will be in Auckland, where the owner is, so Dave will be able to make adjustments and set up the computer to the customer's requirements, because this is a development process. Expecting to get it bang on right the first time is a bit optimistic, but I'm actually really, really happy with the way it's come up so far. I am actually yet to meet this customer, the owner of this car. I haven't even met him. His car came on a truck and we've conversed on the phone. So it will also be good, really good, to catch up with him and see how he drives it and get a bit of a feel, because we didn't get a chance to drive it beforehand because of the state of the engine, and we weren't going to risk damage. It was transported down on a truck for a reason, and we weren't going to risk that damage. So we'll look out for the next one where we head to the dyno. Catch you later.